Do you know the first thing you need to do when you solve a trigonometric equation? And do you know the three basic equations that all trigonometric equations reduce to? By the end of this video, you'll find the answer to both of those questions. Welcome to Understand the Math. We've created free guided notes that you can use as you watch this video and placed a link to them in the video description below. There's space in the notes where you can fill out the answers to the examples that we're going to do and learn more. Because you can't just watch someone do math, you need to do it too. A trigonometric equation is an equation that involves trigonometric functions of an unknown angle. Solving a trigonometric equation involves finding all values of the unknown angle that make the equation true. A trigonometric equation is true for certain values of the angle. This is in contrast to a trigonometric identity that is true for all values of the angle. The first thing you need to do when solving a trigonometric equation is to find out which of the five main types of equations you're trying to solve. The first type of trigonometric equation is an equation with a single trigonometric function. I've listed five examples here. The second type is a trigonometric equation with trigonometric functions that contain multiples of an angle. The equations shown here have an angle other than theta. The third type is equations with multiple trigonometric functions that can be factored. You can see in each of these three equations that there is a trig function that's common to both terms and can be factored out. The fourth type is equations written in quadratic form. These types of equations can be solved by factoring the quadratic. The last type is equations that can be solved using a trigonometric identity. I have a video for each of these five types of problems, and I walk through solutions to all the equations that I've listed. All five of these trigonometric equations reduce to a basic trigonometric equation. A basic trigonometric equation can be written in the form T of theta is equal to a constant. We call T of theta our trigonometric function. There are six different types of trigonometric equations. And I've listed them here. Let's notice that equations 4, 5, and 6 can be written to look like equations 1, 2, and 3 by using a cofunction identity. Because of this, we can say that all trigonometric equations reduce to one or more of the following equations. The first one is sine theta is equal to c, where c can take on any value between minus 1 and 1. The second type is cosine theta is equal to a constant. And for this equation, C also can range between minus 1 and 1. Our third type of equation is tangent theta is equal to a constant, where the constant can be any number. So our constant can range between minus infinity and infinity. Let's now learn about solutions to equations of the form sine theta is equal to a constant. I've graphed y is equal to sine theta and two lines y is equal to c. One with c positive and one with c negative. You can see from the graph that there are an infinite number of solutions between minus infinity and infinity. If we look between 0 and 2 pi, so we're focusing on this region, we can see that there are two solutions. When sine theta is positive, there is one solution between 0 and pi over 2. That's the solution that lies between 0 and pi over 2. That solution is in the first quadrant. There is also one solution between pi over 2 and pi. The solution between pi over 2 and pi lies in the second quadrant. When sine theta is equal to a negative number, one solution lies between pi and 3 pi over 2. The solution between pi and 3 pi over 2 lies in the third quadrant. And the other solution lies between 3 pi over 2 and 2 pi. The solution between 3 pi over 2 and 2 pi lies in quadrant 4. Let's recap this. When sine theta is positive, there's one solution in the first quadrant and one solution in the second quadrant. And when sine theta is negative, there's a solution in the third quadrant and a solution in the fourth quadrant. Solutions to equations of the form cosine theta is equal to c can be found in a similar manner. There's an infinite number of solutions between minus infinity and infinity, and there's two solutions between 0 and 2 pi. When cosine theta is positive, there's one solution between 0 and pi over 2, and there's one solution between 3 pi over 2 and 2 pi. These solutions are in quadrant 1 and quadrant 4. When cosine is equal to a negative number, there's one solution between pi over 2 and pi, and then one solution between pi and 3 pi over 2. These solutions are in quadrant 2 and quadrant 3. As a recap, when cosine is positive, there will be a solution in quadrant 1 and in quadrant 4. And when cosine is negative, there'll be a solution in quadrant 2 and in quadrant 3. We'll end by learning about solutions to equations of the form tangent theta is equal to c. Just like sine and cosine, there are an infinite number of solutions between minus infinity and infinity. Between minus pi over 2 and pi over 2, there is one solution. When tangent theta is positive, there's going to be a solution between 0 and pi over 2. And this solution resides in the first quadrant. When tangent is equal to a negative number, there's going to be one solution between minus pi over 2 and 0. And this solution lies in quadrant 4. So as a recap, if tangent's positive, we'll have a solution in the first quadrant. And if tangent is negative, we'll have a solution in the fourth quadrant. The next video in this series walks through 5 example problems of solving equations like we've talked about in this video that have a single trigonometric function. If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.